Some of the outskirts and back alleys of Venice Beach. We're here with one, a performer, and the other is what he calls a life artist. So let me introduce you to two of my friends, Patrick and Sonny. How are you guys doing today?
Good.
You mind if I sit?
No, please,
no?
Please.
So what's going on? What are you doing out here?
Chilling,
trying to, just trying to live.
How long have you been out here?
A lot. I haven't been out here as long as Sonny. I just came out here from Germany November 07.
November 07, okay.
I didn't even know Venice was a part of LA.
How about you, Sonny?
I've been here for on and off 5 years.
5 years, wow.
I always come back here.
What draws you to this area here? What's so
the
great
ocean.
About it? The ocean? How's that make you feel?
Good.
Yeah? Why do you tell us about it?
It's pretty, and it's the ocean, and it's what the whole world shares, the ocean.
Now, I love your artistic appearance. Can you explain some of these? You know, because we're in a generation where people get tattoos and earrings, nose rings. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Him?
Yeah. Both of you, yeah, each one, yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, I like it because first of all, my first tattoo was for Dolly.
What was your first tattoo?
That was this and that. It just being different. After I got my first earrings, because my stepfather at one point said, if you ever get an earring, I'll rip it out. And I got my first earring, he didn't rip it out. So I got my second, third, fourth, and it just kept on going. And then I just wanted to be different, because I was already different, being a mutt and all.
Being a mutt?
Yeah.
What's your background?
Oh, I have so many. My mom is half Indonesian, half Dutch. My father is Irish-American. And yeah. All mixed up.
And how about you, Sonny?
I'm Nigerian.
You're Nigerian? Which part of Nigerian? Lagos?
I have no idea, but I know that
Nigeria?
I'm Nigerian.
Wow. I know a lot about Nigeria. One of my best friends is a professor.
Do I look Nigerian?
I try not to go by appearance.
And I don't.
You're a Nigerian. If you're Nigerian, you're Nigerian.
I really believe it.
Well, they told you were,
born
right?
In Tennessee, though.
You were born in Tennessee, okay.
Don't tell me not Nigerian.
Do you have brothers and sisters? And
I have one brother.
Where are they?
He lives in Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Oh, they're in Tennessee still.
I live in Nashville. Well, I'm from Nashville.
Okay.
And my brother lives in Chattanooga.
Right. How about you, Patrick? Do you have brothers and sisters?
I have one brother. He's 2.5 years younger, and he's my idol.
He's your idol? Wow.
He's so much stronger than I am.
Yeah, are you, you know, some people don't like the term.
Mentally.
Okay.
I look up to him.
Wow. Some people don't like that term, homeless. How do you guys classify
houseless.
That? You're houseless.
Houseless.
How long have you been houseless?
Off and on for 10 years.
Wow.
In Europe and here.
Can you tell us, give us an idea of where you might sleep? What's your daily activity consist of?
Wherever I can, I'll lay my head. If possible, now, after all this time, inside, whether that be a van, RV, or whatever, or a squat, inside, preferably. But if not, then it's always nice to sleep outside again.
It's always nice. Do you feel the same way?
I like sleeping outside.
Do you get heckled by the cops a lot?
Yeah, but it's always funny.
Do you feel that they judge you at all?
Well, they think I'm like a piece of shit or something, but I don't actually do anything, you know? And I think it kind of boggles them, it mind boggles them. Because I don't do anything, and they expect me to be this type of criminal, but I actually just kind of enjoy the way I'm living. have friends and I have family that would take me in any second, and I really don't want that.
So you've chosen this lifestyle.
Yes.
What brings a person to that point where you choose this kind of lifestyle?
I think it's the change. Times are just changing. People are getting fed up. And at one point, just say, fuck it all. Fuck it all. I don't want to be a part of your system.
I just like the freedom in it all.
That's
like, if I want to, I can say, I'm going to San Francisco tomorrow. And I will go.
How do you get there?
I just paint job for $45 and I take the Greyhound.
You play guitar?
Yeah.
You too, Patrick?
I wish.
I play guitar.
I'm your biggest groupie.
You want to play a little guitar?
I'll play some guitar.
All right. Hey, Patrick, I love the markings on your face.
Thank
what do
you
they represent?
Much. Well, actually, I've wanted tattoos in my face for very, very long, like over 10 years. And Sunny happened to have a issue of profane existence. And there was a drawing of a Pawnee warrior, and he had these tattoos in his face. And I said, that's it. And I don't know the meaning exactly. The first couple of months, I was always saying, well, it means soul cleansing. And then I got fed up of constantly explaining to people what it's supposed to mean. And now I'm saying it's my war paint against the government and the cops.
It has that appearance, you know. That's a good question. You call yourself a life artist. What does that mean?
Well, life artist is just coping with life all over the world. And being able to adjust all over, no matter what. That's, for me, a life artist.
How do you think people, this might be a tough question, but how do you think people perceive you?
I don't really care, as long as they try to open their mind and see me as who I am, and not what I'm throwing out there. If they try to see behind the wall, then they're okay.
Yeah, I want to say that, you know, I guess being a professor and educating people and talking about perception and all the different theories, I think I've come less or more to terms with not judging people than I would have in the past. So when I see people who are made up, I want to get to know them. I want to figure out.
That's what I read in your book.
Yeah, I want to figure out what their world, what you know, what ticks, what makes them tick in this world. That's why I ask you these questions, because it's cool, you know.
Thank you.
And I know how people stereotype so much.
They do. And I always said, since I was a kid, I've been harassed by cops in Germany and Louisiana, and I've always said, you can't put me in any drawer. There's no drawer that can fit me.
Wow.
Even though I'm so small.
And Sonny, what are you gonna do? Come on, what do you got, Sonny?
I'm gonna play some
Let It Be or something,
I'm
Beatles?
I'm gonna play some Nashville blues that I wrote.
Nice, let's hear it.
But I'm not gonna sing.
No, you're not singing. know it?
It's yeah.
All right.
But it's my
old time.
Yeah, my time.
She said,
ooh.